Diagnosis must be the exact history and the symptoms of the patient's notice, followed by problem-oriented imaging, except in multiple trauma patients. In this case, usually we done polytrauma CT scan to include our injuries. For the first, we use conventional X-ray. We spoke about this and enter the posterior approach, the lateral approach. If you want to show the intervertebral foramina, you make the oblique approach or special X-rays, for example, from the odontoid process open mouth view. If we excluded the fracture, we want to examine the disco ligament or instability. So we make the flexion and extension use from anterior to posterior. Visualization of the anterior cervical spine is necessary. If we have a problem with conventional fluoroscopy, we make the CT scan or MRI. Additionally, if we claim the dorsal approach, we make the MRI scan with angiography to describe the position of the vertebral artery. That's exact imaging of the spine, X-ray, anterior, posterior, and laterally, and you can see the whole cervicospine, C1 to C7, and TH1. If you make the view to control the dense position, you make the open mouth X-ray, and on the left side, you can see the cervical spine is not completely on these views. So, if we have excluded the fractures of the bone, we make the dynamic views in the anteroflexion and retroflexion to control the distance between the vertebral bodies, but excluded the disc and ligaments injuries. On the right side, on the left side of this picture, excuse me, we have ultrasound findings. CT or MRI is necessary in this case. You can see only the upper cervical part with C1 to C5, and we cannot describe C7 and TH1. So we make the CT scan as on the right side without the pathology. We have the beautiful methods, diagnostic methods to plan the operation set, the access. For example, the combination of CT and three-dimensional views. We have MRI to describe not only the fractures, bone injuries, we can describe the pathologies in the ligaments and this such as you. I want to show you an our case. It is 74 years old man. He climbed on the plumb tree and fell down from 3 meters high. He was admitted in our department at night. I had a call. Professor Dras were not here. They had the symptoms, back pain, and no pathologies, but no symptoms, neurological symptoms. We have done a CT scan and saw the luxation fractures TH9, TH2. As you can see, these CT scans, and you can see the completely destroying of the pedicle contact to the vertebral body, both sides. So whole arch is dislocated. I decide to do it percutaneously, such as the second presentation for me, Professor Grass was not here. And we have done this instrumentation with 4 small incisions and reposed the fracture Krakatausi. Picture number one on the left side show the position of the pedicle screws and the long instruments. We show the workshop after this presentation and show the videos from the operation. And the picture in the middle, it's a dorsal bend under posterior view during the operation after the fixation of the stabs. On the right side of the deals, you can see the end results during the operation. And the second step was done by Professor Grass with the ventral fusion because of the high instability grade. The patient was admitted in Reha clinic and without neurological complications. The end. He sent pictures after, before we admitted him to the clinic. The next case, 84-year-old patient with morbus Forestier, Marcomar therapy by arrhythmia absoluta. As usual, casual fall at home, admitted to the hospital. The symptoms were only neck and head pain. The CT scan was done. We have served small circular hematoma, X-ray, cervical spine without pathology. If you look at this picture, it's only morbus Forestier. But there was some problem. This small disruption of the ventral ligament by calcification. The other one symptoms of the pain. We have controlled it by CT scan. The colleague of the duty of the colon of this hospital made a functionality control because of to exclude its location. And the patient was monitoring 24 hours. During this monitoring, he reported a strong pain on the cervical part of the spine, and the next day reported about paraplegia. As we observed, we saw the paraplegia. We made MRI and saw the instability in this part of the cervical spine. The operative treatment was done, the ventral approach, corporectomy, and stabilization with the cage. The patient was admitted 12 days after the operation to Reha Hospital with declining neurological symptoms. The case number three, it was a female, 51 years old, 2006, traffic injury with flexion distraction force. You can see this terrible luxation fracture, TH3, TH6, with paraplegia. We stabilized this fracture by Dr. Heineck, our colleague, with the dorsal stabilization, but the ventral fragment of this fracture was dislocated still. Dr. Heineck has done a key wire through the around the spine and push this ventral part on the spine. That's the picture CT scan after this operation. It's a classical surgery. 2 years after this procedure was the material removing was done. Only one part of the screw is still and the cerebellar wire. Case number four, 23 years female, 2008 car traffic injury, flexion distraction force, and a family free fracture with C6 fracture, combination of both. We all knew about 20% of the fractures are on the one or more level. So we control every time the pole is flying by one level of friction. We have done the diagnosis with conventional X-rays, and you can see these parts, C2, C3, is not correct. And we have seen the fraction gap polygraph. The CT scan was done. You can see this fracture with this dislocation. You look better. And on this scan, you can see the next level of the injury. The whole spine CT was done to exclude the normal injuries. And we make the open reduction, ventral fusion with bone grafts on the C2, C3 level with locking plates. And by young people 22 years old, we make temporary fusion with locking plate C6, C7. This operation, one step operation, was done. After 3 months, we remove the down plate as a temporary osteosynthesis. The upper plate, still by patient, there was no neurological complications. Let me conclude. X-ray is a standard method for the primary diagnostic of the spine fracture. CT scan is a gold standard for diagnostic of the osteosynthesis and planning the correct treatment and treatment way. MRI is a helpful method to exclude discs and ligaments injuries, and in special kind, you can visualize the arterial placement and exclude an anatomical aberration. As structure shall be regarded as injury until it is definitely excluded. You can use a CT, MRI, and combination of both if you need. Primarily, we use the X-ray examination, and to bone injuries, the diagnosis of bone injuries, we use a CT scan, and to control the discs and ligaments, the soft tissues, we do MRI. Thank you for your attention.